Greetings, YouTubers. This is Vince, and welcome to Sandbox Junkies. This is my channel, first video, super excited. So, I'm going to tell you what we're going to be doing today. We're going to be doing a Let's Build. It is my play on the Let's Plays. This is going to be a series of videos, starting first with Stonehearth, but it will feature other videos as we go down the road. It's going to feature mainly building games. You have to, some of the rules for this series is you have to, have the ability to build. Be it Minecraft, building your own houses block by block. This game where you design floor layouts, walls, games like Timber and Stone, where you're still doing it block by block, but in a, kind of manager, town building style. I'll have Fortress Craft, I'll have 7 Days to Die, I'll have all these games on this series of videos, and each series will be an ongoing series where we will build up a world together. If you see something you think I should do and I haven't done it yet, please leave a comment and I will get to it. So let's get started with Stonehearth. Stonehearth is a town-building game. It is going to be managing a group of villagers as they build and survive in a hostile world where goblins like to burn your stuff. Last time I played this was a few alphas ago. I think it was Alpha 4. This one's Alpha 6, as you can clearly see. And it's release 156, which just came out 2 days ago. I tried recording this video yesterday and had so many bugs with the building error, and I think that was all user-related bugs, not the game. I tried to do some stuff this game just couldn't handle quite yet. And I'm going to try those stuff again, but I think I know how to do it this time. But let's get started and you'll see what I mean. So let's do a normal game because, you know, peaceful is boring. Who wants to watch? Well, nothing happens besides the building. You want a challenge. Let's look for a good lush. See if... Ooh, did you see that? Ah, that's a beauty. Ridiculously lush. Let's go for it. If you notice those flickerings, it was just me starting my timer video. Last time I tried recording a video for my YouTube channel a few days ago, I went into like 45 minutes of video and didn't know where to cut it off, so I wanted a timer this time so I can keep an eye on things and make sure we don't... Can you see what I see? Oh, I see this really beautiful spot with lots of food and plenty of room to build. And it's semi near the edge, but we have all this room and we could actually even kind of build. Oh, there's a lot of trees. See if we find a more open space with a lot. Oh, yeah. I see where a town's going to go, and we'll be right next to the border, so we can eventually get a road straight to the border. That will be nice. Not sure if this game is like Timber and Stone, though. If you get something to the border, you get more traders coming to you, and the ability to get villagers in. Don't think it's there yet, but I see a bunch of food here and here, and plenty of room to build. So let's go ahead and plot our place down right here. This sounds good. Where's Cherryton? I like the west part. I'm not sure about the Cherryton. Let's go West Grove. This will be in the town of West Grove, which is a nice, you know, generic town name for a fantasy setting. And here's all of our villagers. Oh, look at this art style. This art style is so crisp and clean. Man, that guy got some nice mutton chops. Ooh, look at those mutton chops. Okay, so let's say a lot, because that's apparently what I do. I was actually watching the news the other day, and noticed the reporter who was on this national news program, I think it was CNN's Wolf program, I don't know, it was something, I was in a dealership and it was on, and I noticed that the news caster kept saying, this financial information, this financial information, she kept saying, a lot, which always to me sounded unprofessional, but I guess since they could do it, I could do it. Ooh, did you see that? We had a notification. A traveler approaches holding a bundle. Woohoo! Basket of berries! Oh, look at that! We got a basket of berries! Nice! Okay, let's get a, standard stockpile. If any of you have, played Banished or any of these, town-building survival games, this will be familiar to you. Let's go ahead and plop that down right now. It'll hold everything because we don't have another place for it. Another thing we might want to do is start getting some of this food. We'll come up here, get this food and this food. Oh, this is going to be nice. Nice, nice, nice. Let's go ahead and chop that down. I want to get this food in. This is going to be so nice. We're going to build up this town to be so nice, so big. Look at all this room. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I didn't see these down here. That was too close to the edge. I don't like building too close to the edge. Then I feel limited on room. But this is going to be nice. But you know what? Since this stuff is here, let's harvest it. I don't want to cut down too many trees because I don't think there's a way of replanting trees yet. But we do need some wood. God, food everywhere. I guess this is why it's ridiculously lush. Let's cut down these trees right here. That stone and those flowers. Let's take a look. Who do we have in our village? Actually, you know what? I'm going to individually name my villagers. No, not yet. I'll name my villagers next time. Autumn Whale, Allin Founder, Chopper, Kuroda? I guess that's how you'd say that. Heather Homer, Fasten Adian, Devona, Hunterton. Okay, you know what? Her last name is Hunterton. Let's make her a hunter. I mean, come on. That one had to be obvious. Okay, Kevin Open? Caven. Let's make Caven, our carpenter, which we need to do pretty much anything else in this game. Let's see. Can I go to him? No. Let's keep an eye on this because look at the visual when the person comes to pick this up. It's going to be awesome. Here he comes. Wow. It's Zelda all over again, only without the music of the opening of the chest, which... Ah, memories. Okay, let's begin getting our person. We want to create a trap zone for our trapper. I'm going to dedicate this large area over here. Trapping. Look at the rabbits. God, I love the art style of this game. I know it's voxely, but it's smooth. It's like, it's not ugly voxels. I've seen some ugly voxel games, and I will play some of those, because the gameplay is awesome. But as far as art style, the cleanness of this, the brightness and vibrance, just feel of this game, it's just amazing. I immediately fell in love with it when I found it while looking up, games like Timber and Stone, which I will be playing. Timber and Stone, it might seem similar to this game, but it's not really anything like this game, all besides the fact that both are town-building games. That's the only thing they have in, similarity. But enough of that, time is ticking on, and we need to get some other stuff done besides gathering food. I want to get our carpenter, build his workshop. I'm going to go ahead and build it right here for now. We'll move it. And what do you think? Should we do the carpenter's workshop first? Yeah, let's do that instead of just individual housings. The building, housing building system in this game is really nice. It's not complete yet. I hope they add the ability to add interior walls without having to trick the system, which can bug the game out. Which I will be saving before we get into that. I should have enough time to design it and semi-design it. We won't be able to get the furniture in just because I have to build all that yet. Let's do the designing of the carpenter's workshop on the next video. Let's get our farm and guards in because we are going to be getting attacked. Let's make some furniture. Let's make a few of those. We need at least one door for that. I generally put a lot of windows in. I like areas to look like they have a lot of natural light coming in, especially since I don't have the ability to build any of these lanterns yet. I don't know when I get the ability. They added a new RPG system to your villagers, and so you're now limited on what you can build when you start out, which is nice. I'm liking that aspect. I like the RPG feel of it, where you gotta actually make your people work to get stuff done. That's the only thing with a game like Banished I did not like was everything was accessible. You just had to work for the materials. I like a progression system, and this game has that. So you see our carpenter is working. Look, watch this animation. I love the visuals of this game. Oh, sweet. He leveled up. The carpenter can now make a solid array of basic furniture. Nice, and he gained 10 hit points. Let's go to his character sheet. Do we want to keep his name Kevin Open? I like the Caven. Caven is okay. Let's remove the Okay, let's just rename him Caven. Caven Woodwork. Because, I mean, we have Hunterton. Why not Woodwork? That's going to be nice. Also, listen to the music. It has the opening feel of Lord of the Rings, the Fellowship of the Ring. It just has that Hobbiton feel from the Shire. Ah, I love this game. Sorry, I keep going on that I love this game. For those of you who haven't played it, it did at the time. I'll have to get the price now, but at the time when I bought it, I got it for $15. I didn't get immediate access. I had to wait for a public alpha version to come out, which came out probably about 2 weeks after I paid the $15 for it. In order to get in the alpha beforehand, you had to pay $30. I'm not sure what the price is at the moment. I will have that down in the description. Okay, so we have those guys. We should have our tools. Who do we want to make? Let's see. You know what? Do you have a job yet? She's just a worker. Let's make you a guard, and that her name was Autumn at the time. I want to look at her. There is a certain name I like to go with for my defensive people, and that's Kamiko. Now, the last name, I usually go with Yuzumaki. I don't know why, I just like this name, and she kind of fit the look. So she'll be our apprentice footman for right now. Oh, sweet, our trapper leveled up. Devona Hunterton. Oh, she got pelt. Nice. What's she doing? Long walks have increased the trapper's foot speed. Nice, she could walk faster than that. Oh, I see a fox. Oh, should I make that reference? Nah, that song was just too horrible. And besides, no one wants to listen to what a fox says. Oh god, I just made the reference, didn't I? Oh god. Okay. Let's get ready to call it here. We got that. Let's get our farmer made before we end this here. I know I didn't go with why didn't her name stick? In fact, his name didn't stick. What the heck? I don't know what happened. I don't know why it didn't stick. Let's see if it sticks that time. I hit enter. Maybe I didn't hit enter last time. Let's see? It stick? That time it stuck, so let's rename Kevin here. Kevin. What did I name him? I named him Wood something. What did I name him? Oh my god. I'll just name him Kevin Wood. Kevin Wood. Kevin. He's Kevin Wood. Yeah, that'll be good. I'll name him that. Let's look at it. So he only has level 1, but that's what he can get at level 6. Attributes, morale. Okay. Make sure that's stuck. And that is the sound of my timer going off, telling me I should end the video as soon as possible. So I'm going to do that. I just want to assign our farmer. Who's the guy with the mutton chops? I don't want to be stereotypical, but he has to be our farmer. Chopper? Ah, I could have remade him the, carpenter. Oh well, he's going to be our farmer. And I'm going to rename him completely. He is going to be, not Bob. Shoot. Actually, you know what? You guys come up with a name for the farmer, and I'll name him that. Try to make it kind of comical and make sense for a farmer. A blonde farmer with mutton chops, because that's what he is. Okay, I'm going to save it here. And exit the game, and that's it. You guys have fun gaming. Until next time, please leave comments, subscribe if you like what I'm doing. You don't feel you have to. Like it if you want. Again, you don't have to. I'm doing this just because I want to do it, and I'm hoping people like what I do. So until next time, I'm out.